everyone knows what a Democrat and Republican is in America. And if you want on issues like abortion, oh, the Democrats are pro-choice and the Republicans are pro-life and so on down the line. Now, if you ask people about populism, there's no populist agenda. And I think the people who got it right actually are the Italians, in the sense that the five-star movement became a political party, but it started off just as a movement. And so that's what I'm sort of hoping will happen, that someone will start to go, hey, this populist thing, let's try to codify all the people you've been interviewing, right? Could we make a list of like five things that they all agree on? Forget the things we don't agree on for a second, which will be issues of trade or some parts of immigration or whatever. Forget that. Are there five things we can agree on, like the rollback of the military-industrial complex, right? Everybody, right? Election reform, to have a democracy that actually functions and works and that people can have some confidence in. I think everybody agrees on that. I think everybody agrees on issues of freedom, rule of law, some human rights stuff, not all. But you don't need everything, because if you had like this movement of people who could be like, I'm a Republican populist, and that means I adhere to these five principles, or I'm a Democrat populist, it means I adhere to these same five principles as this Republican. That's why, you know, when I see someone like Ocasio-Cortez, mm-hmm. when I see what's happening with Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, she's a leftist, right? But I'm, yeah, all right, right on, because she's anti-war. And
which is why so many people went from Bernie to Trump. They weren't going to Trump at all. They were attracted to the anti-war platform.